Hello everybody. Today I will show you the third part of my connection, RS-232 connection with the GSM modem. This time I will send SMSs through the modem to my to any number. Now, why you need it? You need first you can use web gateway like telemessage.com and send 500 or 2000 SMSs. But first it will cost you about, if I'm not wrong, something like 10 cents. But you can also use your GSM SIM card to send SMSs through the night. Generally, people don't talk through the night for the 12 hours at the evening. And the GSM the SIM card is the same amount wherever you talk all the time or you don't talk any minute, the same comes for SMS. So you can use this SIM card to send SMSs at night. Now I have this program, it's called My Office 24, and it's for my opinion a very very good program. I have here email client, very basic email client, inbox and send items as you saw the tabs, and very nice contacts list over here. What I added here is an applet that send SMSs. I will press SMS plus. You will see all that the contacts that you have here. You will see listed that have, for example, I will open this guy. It's my dentist. He has a number here, so this number will be shown at the over here, the list here. But if, as you see here, but if he doesn't have a cellular phone in that field, you will not see his number here, because he probably will not see any message if you send SMS message to his home phone. Generally, most of the odds that he will not see this message. Now you can make with my program lists of groups, and of course any group you can choose here, but I made a group called RS-232 just for checking purposes. It's good because all these lists and that group sends to the same number. For my number, cellular number, to check it. I cannot bother people and harass them by sending text messages because I want to check the program in various hours during the day. Another option, very very good feature, is to send messages personally. If you check this checkbox, you can add any opening phrase you like. For example, now it's evening. I will say, good evening. It's very simple and banalic, but I hope there is a word in English like this. But it's very, very simple. So good. Hi, friend. I can send. It tells you that you use 9 characters in the greetings. And it asks how many letters do you want to program to send from the first name, because if his first name is very long, like 10 characters and you want to include 10 characters, there will be very little, because one person have 10 characters and other have little, you will lose a lot of characters from the main text box, the main message. All the message you have altogether 160 characters in English to send. In Hebrew you have, if I'm not wrong, 70 only. And I will touch the Hebrew later. So in English, so let's say if you have 9 here and 5 letters for private name, like let's say John will be included because it's less than 5 letters, but Shoshik will be, it will write hi friend and then pause, and then Shoshik is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 letters. If you want such, it will write Shosh. It will write Shosh in this example, which is not a bad name here, because you concatenate last two letters. But if you will check this one, which has 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, it will send 5. It will call him Sulim. So you check this 7 to 7 letters. That's what I made the maximum, even though I can change it very easily. It will include all this, all the first name from this guy. So he will send hi friend Suleiman and the message itself. Now let's see, if you have 9 letters for greetings, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 149 plus 1, it's 150, and 7 letters for the private name at 153, FF 157, and there is two more, that one is it's like a comma after the name, and the other is a space after the comma, so we had one space for one characters for 160. It made me problems. I tell you the truth, when I choose the until up to the last character available, sometimes it sent the message, sometimes I get errors. And for this, I chose to send maximum characters of 159 and not 160 characters. Now I can write here whatever I like. Please come, please visit my website for updates, because I have a new applet to offer you. You can see what is about and tell me if you need any help to upgrade it to, you see, here it says how many characters left, and here the total characters in this message, and not including the first name and the greeting. I was in the mood to write, like, I think 200 letters now, but I see that it stopped me. You see, I press now and I cannot go any further. If you're interested in that, no, it will not in it, and a comma at the end. So again, I chose my my list that is all sending to my number. My number is listed here. And the first number, I did a mistake by itself. It's, you see, only instead of 7 and 3, which is 10 digits, you have here only 5 digits. Of course, there is no such cellular number. It will throw an error. I have to mention, after I will start it, you can start via send, press F11 to send via Telit module or the SIM900L module, it's the same, or with telemessage, but you have to pay them. It will send through telemessage with their gateway, and you have to, they will charge you each SMS. So I will change via Telit modem. It will open this terminal on the side, and while it's sending, I wanted to inform that sometimes you can send to numbers that are not normal, and it will tell you, it will get a response that it's okay. For example, you can send SMS to 10 times the digits 1, and it will tell you, the modem will get response from the cellular company that it's okay. I don't know where is this family, this number is coming from, is if there is such a number or whatever, wherever I got to, whatever device anywhere I got, but it gives you it gives you a normal response, like there is such a number. Now I want to check something else. Generally, the first error, it says, is success to this number. The number was short, as I mentioned. It says success false. And this is the message itself. Hello, friend John. You see, it was John here, first name. Hello, friend John. Please visit my web, and so on and so forth. The zero at the end, forget the zero now. Hello, now, to be honest, the all as you see, these two panels, these two forms are synchronized between one another. Whenever this gets answer, it sends this, and whenever this has a new number, it sends this, and they are working together. But the second error, maybe there is no such number, because here it's, but I think, no, sorry, this one, this, I'm not sure why it gave why it gave the error. You see, sending to Rami over here, you see, finish success, hello, just a minute, hello Rami. Over here is sending to Rami, and it was false. And also here it informed you it's false. Why it is false, why it is error over there, I'm not sure for now. But let's continue to send all other SMSs and see that they are okay. Of course I could hide this form. Or you can tell me why do I need this? First, as a developer, I need this because I want to see the reaction from the modem. And I didn't hide it because I think that the users are very intelligent and very smart, and they should see what is going behind. And I should not hide it from them. It's very simple to hide it. Third, I added because this form have a code behind that serves three applets, two Ipon SMS applets and this applet. altogether. So I don't need to write, it's a very modular code writing. I don't need to write the code three times again and again to connect to an external GSM modem. No, I write it once, and each applet will talk to this module. This way I can change something in this module and all three applets will get the change, because this is the base. And this sends the requests and get the answers from the GSM modem for all three applets. As the end of the end of the list, it show you some statistics, successfully sent 8 and failed 2. Total messages are 10, and also here you can see through the sending procedure how many messages are sent. And the last one was Michelle. So Michelle Pfeiffer got the message. I can close. Before I will close, I will say something about the Hebrew. Getting Hebrew from the model is optional and it's possible. But I just have to see something and tell you on the spot, because I don't like to add a small writings through the video. I don't like to edit anymore. I'm very, very sloth. I'm very sloth in this. I don't have time for this. I don't do it. So the Unicode characters, these are the list, for example. If you want to get Hebrew Aleph, you should send this code in decimal and this code in hexadecimal. In hexadecimal, it's 2 digits. In decimal, it's 4 digits. And in binary, each decimal is 8 digits. So you have to send, and this is how it's actually sending, 4 times 8 means 32 bits for one character in Hebrew. While in English, it needs only 8 bits, not 32. That's why you can send much more characters in English and not in different languages like in Hebrew. So it's not possible to send SMSs in Hebrew to send them, because even though I tried to code Hebrew, I spent about full days just to be able to send one character in Hebrew through SMS, and it's not possible because the hardware, it's not the software, the hardware does not support Hebrew, and that's it. It filters Hebrew, it filters other characters except Chinese if it's come from the SIM, the SIM 900L, or other languages that are important to the manufacturer. So sending, if you try, for example, to write hello instead of Shoshik here in English, you will write it in Hebrew, it will write an error for you, and it will not send it. It will, because it sees Hebrew, it cannot send half Hebrew and half English. It will say this SMS is dismissed, is obliterated. Now, once I close this main pane, he says he wants to close connection. Yes, I want to close the connection. It's good to do. And it closed, but generally it would close both of them. If you close the main pane, it will close both of these. If you close this one, you don't need to close the main pane. The main pane will stay. Now you can go to the log. And at the log, you see, hello, hi, friend, Michelle, and all this. And these, the number that John Doe did not, the other SMS number are just for check. Please concentrate of these two. These are errors. And all these are, you see V in here, and are not background in red. It means the SMS went okay to this recipient. Sorry. You have to close it and open. I have to add the filtering event. Once you press here, it changes the list. And if it changes the list, the back color changes. But you can see that these eight are okay. You can delete them if you like. I will delete one. And for these people, and these two people did not get the SMS. Let's see something. So this small bug that John Rami Maluli did not get the SMS, it's a bug. I know where it comes from. I have to go a little bit back to the code. I wanted to save some time by sending and waiting, and I think that's what caused this problem. I have to decrease a little bit the time, and it will be okay. So generally, this is all the what this applet is doing, sending SMSs, let's say free, from your SIM card. And of course, you can write here all 160 characters. This is some code that if I write 123, it will fill the text box with junk of 150 characters. But if I write A, B, C, you see, it gave me only 100 and sorry, A. It starts from 100. This is a small bug I want to check, because it should start now. It should write 159 or 158 characters left. Or I think through the GSM modem there is a bug for these last two characters. I wanted to, if I'm not wrong, it's not one character less, it's two characters less. So let's see, one ABC, it's 155, and three more, 158, and I left two characters for preventing errors, let's call it like this. So thank you for watching. I hope you will use my program.